Afternoon. Welcome to our capital conference. We've got Mzwandile Stick, Siya Kolisi. Raise your hands for.
Yes, I think.
I think for us, it's about our preparations. We don't really focus too much on what other people think about who we're going to see. At the end of the day, we'll play the game between the four. It's always been our policy. We always announce our team early in the week. And even, yes, I think he only probably missed the Saturday session that we had. You know, he was there, but he didn't session. Once again, when it comes to our policy, you know, and on Monday and Tuesday, you've got a chance to make a squad, you know, and internally we knew that Gavin was on standby, you know, but it's just that because of us, he had to announce the team on Tuesday. So internally, Gavin was always there, you know, so we wanted to give him a chance, you know, from Monday, Tuesday, he was training full out, and then also on Wednesday, so he didn't miss any training session. So there's no reason for us not to let him in. He's good. Yeah, I think having him on the bench, I think he will bring probably a mess needed. And we selected strong team. Look at a guy like Peter Steph Tutoi, and Rowan is actually now having his opportunity. We're impressed with his performance. He's got a massive work rate. And then, like, once again, the game of against the All Blacks, you know, you're probably going to have to play until the last second. Once again, to have guys like Kevin, the impact that we're looking for, and the guys like Kwan. So I think those are the guys that we are needed. We won't make any changes. Just have with you. Start the game.
What did you
recognize? It means a lot to a lot of us in the team who probably when we were younger would have received those packages. So it is important, like, all of us to use what we have in our platform to be able to make a difference. Some people can't do it financially. Some people do it time or all sort of things. So I think for us as a group, you know, South Africa has given a lot. People do spend a nice bit of money to buy a ticket. Yes, it is important. And I know a lot of players do it, you know, some do it privately. People know. Big thing.
Yeah,
me too. It's tough because you a little bit disconnected. Life is completely different. I think that's what I've missed, isn't it? Seeing everything that we play for each and every season, I think it makes use of it. I think it's something that I think if you play in South Africa, you take it for granted, like me, to go and realize that being home, speaking to us or, you know, going to the township. So, and like I said, like we speak about it all the time. We are motivated and we are playing for the people of South Africa being here. That gives us, you know, that gives you the motivation to see each and everything. You drive around or go somewhere, you know, you can see the people that you put. So it's been tough, but being back home has been really amazing. It's a couple of months and I've really enjoyed it and it's like I haven't left. So yeah, it's really been, but I've never lost contact to meetings online and to the teammates. you're never really out there. It's just actually been present.
Said, you know, 8 games or something, beaten in a row. We've beaten them twice in a row now. Do you guys sort of feel motivated to try and get two more, you know, four in a row and trouble the good run like that?
We're motivated for tomorrow, I'll be honest. And we're motivated to, we want to try to win tomorrow. So that takes us closer to winning the Freedom Cup. That's all we're thinking about. Everything else in future that we'll see after that. Tomorrow is a big game for us, you know. I know a lot of people will say they have a lot of motivation. We also have a lot of motivation, you know. They've beaten us a lot of times, you know. Some of us in this group have had 57-0 defeat that, you know, we'll never forget that. So tomorrow is an important game for us, and we've got a lot to play for. And, yeah, so that's all we've been focused on. It's just tomorrow.
Coach, in 2022, you guys went to beat them comfortably, then went to Ellis Park and lost that game. Has that inconsistency been a talking point this week for the next 2 weeks?
I think if we go back that far, I think we'll be shooting ourselves on the foot, you know. I think the main focus for us is what we've been trying to achieve this season, because once again, we've got a new personnel also in our squad, you know, I'm talking about coaching-wise. So the key thing for us is just to keep on getting better and improving at the way we want to play the game. And like I always say to people, listen, when you play against the All Blacks, the biggest thing that you must learn is that if you're not switched on the game, they will punish you. So when we played against them at Bombela, probably besides the Faf de Klerk incident, which is it happened the first 2 minutes in the game where he got concussed, I think we started well. We were in control in the game. We put them under pressure, and it was for 80 minutes, you know. Team like them, you can't switch off. So exactly what happened at the Ellis Park, you know. I felt like there in that game, we started slow and the All Blacks were already getting momentum against us in that game at Ellis Park. And they really controlled the game very well and they've managed to put us under pressure and the scoreboard was actually on their side most of the time. We were just unlikely with certain scenarios in the game. If you remember the try that was disallowed, I think it was the Lucanio arm line break, you know, things like that. That's the margin between the orbits, you know. So once again, I think the key thing for us is just to keep on improving and getting better to where we left against Australia. And the lessons that we can take from 2022, yes, can't afford to start slow against it. It has to be an 80-minute performance, and it's something that we've been talking about throughout the whole week against the orbits.
Uh-huh.
So,
yeah,
Leon spoke about you playing overseas, but there's a perception that when you put on the green and gold, you play your best rugby. Is it fair to say that? Is that true? And yeah, and then just speak about your combination now with DJ also now in the newsroom.
I don't know. I try to be at my best wherever I play for my union, because if I don't play well for my union or for my club, then I'm obviously not going to get selected to be here. And it's just here, it's different. I can't explain. And as you say, when you put on the Springbok jersey, there's a lot to play for. And your competition is not the opposition, it's the guys that are playing with you. But it's healthy competition because we're competing. We only compete on Saturday when we play against other teams. But within the group, we are helping. Like Marco is my best coach. Kwaka is my best coach. You know, that's the healthy competition. And then you add on what we're playing for, you know, the people of South Africa. And you know, people talk about like how much pressure the game is because of Coach Rassi said it to us in 2019. We're in a place of privilege, having the honor of representing the whole of South Africa, not just some people of South Africa, everybody in South Africa. And what you do with what you are gifted with, your talent, you can able to control somebody's moods on Monday. I know how nice it is for people on Monday to go in the office and talk about, you know, how lucky the weekend was, Springboks, when they've won. So we think of all of that. So it's just different, you know, putting on a Springbok jersey
And the second question, yeah, BJ is work great and filling with him and obviously Jasper coming back now. We know what Jasper can do. But when it goes to talk about people taking the opportunities, that's what BJ has done. And that's the kind of competition I'm talking about. You can never relax in the Springbok jersey. You can never feel comfortable just because you've earned so many caps. You know, there are guys that are coming, and that's when we're lucky with those forwards in South Africa. We have so many. So, and you can see sometimes every week it's a different team that's playing on. So every time I have the opportunity to play, I want to give absolutely everything because I don't know whether I'm playing next week or not. And you know, the guy that's playing is good enough to be playing in that position too.
You forgot one thing.
Yes.
I must tell him there's no place like home.
Coach, please.
Coach, due to the breakup of the new coaching team, which perhaps is going to be the most chicken to be given that time now, not only dependable, but also showing down. Not people saying it's a bit more, but since he's coming to the spring before, in terms of how the Springboks play, we all play against New Zealand and he's in the fold. Is it a matter of him knowing the DNA of how the home players play in rugby, or do you also take in mind the fact that he might not know what the current home black regime are doing in play? So how do you approach the two dynamics? Do you just lean on his national knowledge of how New Zealand climbing himself against the position in the Springboks, or do you hope that he has some inside camp knowledge of the current regime?
I think for anyone who wouldn't tap in on Tony would probably be stupid, especially when you're playing against the All Blacks. He understands their DNA. He's coached a lot of those players. He's worked with some of those coaching staff. And he has played the game for the All Blacks. So he really understands what triggers them, you know, on the game. You know, so, yes, of course, we did tap in on him and got some good information about what they stand for. And once again, even from the outside, a lot of people, it's clear to see the All Blacks. They take pride in what they do. And rugby will always be one of their biggest, probably weapon in their country, you know. You know, in New Zealand with the population, which is smaller compared to what we have in South Africa, you know. We know everyone in New Zealand. You land at the airport, you meet the old time, he will tell you straight in your face that, listen, you're going to have a tough time. Good luck over the weekend. That's how passionate they are. So we had to tap in from Tony, yes, for sure. And when it comes to their DNA, it's not a secret. The All Blacks will come on top of you. They will try and keep the ball in play, and we are well prepared for that. You know. And one thing that I can tell you also, probably from our side, even before Tony arrived in our team, if you look at the final against them in the World Cup final, probably from the second minute, there was like 4 minute ball in play, you know, and that's the challenge they're going to give to you. They will try and keep the ball as long as possible in play. And once again, I think we are well conditioned for those type of the games now at the moment. And with the balance, also the team that we've selected, if you look at the guys that are starting, listen, to have Peter Steph, Ruan not here, and BJ with Siya, you know, playing together on the field, those guys, they will give you a lot of numbers. And also to be able on the bench, if you look at what we've got, the likes of Ieben and Kwakha, you know, the guys to bring impact. You can't ask for any better balance, you know. And once again, I can also touch in our back line. Yes, Grant Williams, every time he gets an opportunity, he always bring the impact. And we know what we've got in him. And I know a lot of people, they get impatient when it comes to when is he going to start. I think he understands his role at the moment in our team, and he's doing it very well. And once again, to have a solid guy like Andre Pollard, if anything doesn't go well, you saw what happened in the World Cup. Whenever he came off the bench, they've made a difference in the game. So I think we've tried to make sure that we've selected a strong team that will be able to counter everything, anything that the All Blacks will throw at us.
It's feeling is mutual. It's feeling is we even this not hidden. We're very good friends off the field. We get along really well, and we keep in touch all the time, and we respect each other a lot. And we respect each other, especially on the field. By like, I want to make sure that I give him everything I have on the field. And I think that's been the rivalry between us and New Zealand. Yes, we in the field, we give everything we can, and after that, there's mutual respect, you know, after the game. And I think me and Audie have just gotten closer and closer over the years. It's been a couple of years now since we've been good mates. But, you know, people always wonder, like, we're both captain at one time, and people think we want to go half-heartedly to each other. No, it's never like that. I'll gain his respect by giving him everything I can. He'll gain mine by, you know, giving everything can to me. So, yeah, it's always a tough battle. I mean, Sam Kane also back in the squad now. He's been a warrior for the All Blacks for so many years. And Black Adder, he also had another warrior who works hard, just like PJ as well. So it's gonna be a proper battle this weekend, especially in the loose forward and the pack in general.
Stocker, and you guys in the coaching department must be very happy with the development of the squad this season, especially, you know, the inexperienced guys who've come in and really put their hands up. You know, it's not very often that you get to play four guys on the starting lineup and one on the bench with under 10 caps against the All Blacks, and especially when you've got guys like Willie, Andre, and Steven who are fit and could actually be in the group, you know, to be comfortable leaving them out and backing these youngsters. So, you know, this
bodes
very well for the future, and
the government
must be very peaceful about it.
I think, well, like I touched again earlier on, is there to build the squad depth, it will always be part of our goal, which is, again, there will be time where we have to transition, to do the transition as a team, you know. If we're always going to rely on... For example, some of the players we've been with since 2018, they've been doing the job for us. Some are, you know, getting young, you know. So we don't want to wait until we see that we're in trouble. Then all of a sudden, we want to give other guys an opportunity. You know, like I said, a guy like Fassi played well against Australia, played well against Wales when he started against Wales in London. And you can't ask for any better a game where, as a player, you're going to be tested to play against the All Blacks, you know. So, once again, we are rewarding our players. Whoever performs, like Siya just said, now you can't be comfortable in a Springbok jersey, you know. So, as a coaching staff, I think one thing that we are enjoying is the competition, which is the healthy one amongst our players, you know. I think the more competition we get amongst our players, I think the better it is. Again, we want to build for 2027, but at the end of the day, we still want to also be able to win the games now, because the guys that are getting opportunities, like the names you've mentioned, BJ, if he's going to carry on playing the way he's playing, he's probably going to get closer to 80 test matches, you know. I always say to people, like, he reminds me of young Peter Steftutoy, you know. Guy who doesn't hold back, he's like probably one of your biggest bosses. It gives you a lot of battles, and the Rwanda gear, you can see how desperate he is for him to get an opportunity and to perform. So I'm happy for those players. I'm happy that they're also getting rewarded for their performances. And yeah, you can't ask for any better challenge than to show that you've got what it takes to perform at this level than a team like the All Blacks. Yes, also they remember on the other side, they've also got some new faces in that team. You know, to be able, a guy like McKenzie now, where they're showing trust on him, you know, playing week in, week out at 10, you know, that position, probably, if you look at a guy like Maunga, who's been doing the job for them. So they've also got their bit of tests they also need to answer. But once again, like I said, it's a big game. So I hope everyone will be able to get their opportunity.
Thank you, sir.
I was about to actually just elaborate on what you say to that session. On the eve of a test match this week, or the World Cup, they've earned the right to play in this game. But how do you then have to come the next into the World Cup test and every test match, and then you say, you approach a test match with us and being in this game?
I don't think we'll put a lot of pressure on them, you know. Well, the way they've been performing for us, and also in their own personal space, how they normally prepare for the game, I don't think we're going to get involved in that space, you know. But one thing that we've been focusing on during the week as a team is to make sure that we focus on what they do well, you know, what they do best. And a guy like Fass, you have to show trust and give him the freedom to be apelele Fass. Remember, he is here for a reason, because of what he has been doing for the Sharks, you know. Even when he plays in the URC, you see his numbers. he's probably one of the top guys when it comes to the meters and the line breaks. You know, so once again, it will be stupid for us as coaches to say, first, don't look for those opportunities. So I think the key thing for us as coaches is not to put a lot of pressure on him, but first, he must still be first, you know. And you can see a guy like Sasha also, you know, at 10, with the freedom that he's playing with, you know. And yes, he's controlling the game very well. And I can tell you now, they will probably make one or two mistakes. But one thing about them, they won't stop trying. That's one thing that I enjoy about those youngsters. And yeah, hopefully everything goes well. And once again, Kanyiso. If you look at a guy like Sasha, and I remember at Durban, when we played in Durban, played about 78 minutes against the second best team in the world, Ireland, you know. And the way he played in that game, you saw he was really, really trying to bring a positive impact in the game. So if those youngsters, they can keep asking those questions, I think we will be in a better place as a team.
And we lost English question. And then Liam will take you, and then Giles is
and Coach, Spock is a field that's probably made for a nice fast game. Last time we played the All Blacks in the previous game, the Springboks played a forward dominating game. Now it's changed the game plan totally different. So can people look forward to a very fast game against All Blacks tomorrow?
I think if you look at the past couple of games we've played against them, probably I'll even go to 2018. Probably almost all the games that we've played against them, they've been probably one of the best, most entertaining games. You look at how the ending of the game, you know, if you remember in 2018 when we beat them in Wellington, you know, we had to play until the last second when McKenzie knocked the ball, you know, and it was tight. It was a two-point game. And then the following year in Wellington again when we played against them, I think it was Herschel Jankies who scored that final try in the almost the last minutes of the game. You know, so that's one thing about the All Blacks and the Springbok game. It's always entertaining, you know. And I don't think it's going to be different. It's going to be a very, very entertaining game. But once again, just to touch on what you've said about their DNA, that's one thing that I respect about both the teams. We as the Springboks, we've got our own DNA. Even though we still want to build our game, you know, with the presence of Tony, as you can see now at the moment, a lot of wide plays, when we get opportunities, the balls will move into the wider channels. And even in the past, again, like I always say, our DNA doesn't mean that our backline players can't play. You know, if you look at the wings that we're using currently, Kettle is probably now one of the best try scorers. Cheslin Kobe has always been one of the best wings in the world. Makazole Mapimpi, when he got an opportunity, always scoring tries. So it shows at least as a team we are going somewhere, you know, and we're not also not going to drift away from our DNA, you know. Unfortunately, if you don't get momentum in this game and you're not dominating in your set pieces, you're going to have a long day at the office. One thing they've done well against us in Auckland, I think when we played against them last year, if you remember that game we lost, I think physically they pitch up on the game and their kicking game was at the best, you know, and we struggled in that game to get into the game. So I don't think it's a mistake that we want to make against them, you know. So once again, we won't drift away from our DNA. But once again, if there's opportunity for us to spread the ball wide and keep the ball in play, I think we can also leave up there.
Yeah.
Coach, staying with the Ellis Park thing, I see how you can jump in. Ellis Park is up on the ground, talked about a lot in the ball acrobatics, but the results haven't been great against the All Blacks film as well. Do you still see it as an ally?
So if you had to ask the All Blacks at the moment, they'll probably be more comfortable to play at Ellis Park because of the results, you know, and the nature of the game, when you go at Ellis Park, the crowd is like here on top of you. So when you're winning, you will feel the energy from the crowd. And when you don't, things don't go well, you will still also feel that they're going to turn against you because of that's how passionate they are as South Africans, you know. And it's the people that understands the game. And we know the history in that stadium. So a lot of people, they expect us to do well. So I think that is one of the things when it comes to for example, if you play at Bombela, the guys, it feels like it's a different environment, you know, because of all of a sudden when we're at Bombela, the players, they express themselves freely, they just bring their best. Then there's something about Ellis Park where sometimes, even during the good season, one of those bad games, which is against the All Blacks again, we played well at Bombela and then at Johannesburg things didn't go well. Yes, I think there is a bit of a pressure from just the nature of the game at Johannesburg, but we didn't talk too much about it this week. I think the key thing for us was just to focus on what's happening between the four lines. Unfortunately, we don't have control of what's happening on the stands. But I know one thing for sure as South Africans, we are passionate people. So sometimes when things don't go well for us, we know sometimes the crowd at Johannesburg doesn't really stand on our side, but tomorrow we'll do everything in our power to make sure that we keep them in our side.
So your motivation here to Tina City Trimbo and Nalena Bissan to coach in Goku, the land of one Ska win up at Ellis Park, in the Sony Lungis and Naleos Nabatal. Because I asked about the winning child, about the Alabama winning child. So it's 14, about the Kedaka Kulamin, and with the Asbaba Tavan, the Basel Jalabon and Mind, and let's just take you World Cup, Young Land. Not his name motivation is it. Ask your mama born, Baba Susan and Dona. In the ballet, in don't lend a tennis and I, in don't let for new hands and bones. So, not in the strong of Will Tina, city, city, poem, because long game of ballet, the wood take a cool. I think we're going to have to take that city bar. Let me tell you, Swabwe, Australia. It's in the past now. In the ballet, you're putting Oxygen All Blacks. Abaku spaces right. Kuzukumbula bakale slow nabo and then Zindo Baz Chica. I second game with an Argentina. And the London Zamutiba Aukwaz Kalale All Blacks would write off. Cause Zukumbule, Gelatra Sale Nabo and Bombela, Sapumela Nabo the following week, Bali team Bali Kala totally different to Klando Babeyo. So say as Babane players as an expert, but Kala Tim Yabo and in the Bali Gle could make sure. Because of if Bangabe Kalo Oblex, if money momentum, Bukalunzan, Amatu Bago Abuza Fuleka, and then the confidence is saying Yoka Pagubani. So Balegil Putiba, City makes sure as you know, who achieve a game in Bombs. City makes sure Basikalakati, most especially 20 minutes, Salgalunzalo, Ellis Park, and Uzukumbule, Elbala, in the Lencho and Galo, in Atabapanabe. They all play fire and join up the challenge. So in the sales, you know, but not Jim Musevas, the Chiluba, the challenge, Ubas, the history, it would for the past five games. Thing we've only won once. Yabon. So, but legally, land, but say, Lumis, land on the four of our land debate from South Africa. And yeah, hopefully, our support debate about facilitate, but I will be able to go also. And hopefully, Snobaniga, Mzalong Shakakuru for 80 minutes.
And just to make a name, Ufasim, Vamosash, and Abano, Upich, but
I didn't get to know that. It's only a name for my local with one and the Catalan. I didn't plan a city by Buffman in Tuba, about 7 Zelegacool. Ebona Zukumbu, Lago, opportunity Bafana. It was class in Sia Pangapambi, Mfano Jamo Beach, season at Oka Lavagut, and then the last 7 and I have the training sessions. We are born about Mufana, Shem on a future popular carolate. If I'm our climate, so we are essentially planned out in the writing. We are born about Mufana, no governments, and I'm a immediate eliminating Springbok. And then also Tasso Joe Mufana Joe World 1. I'm not here. I want to go Mufana Smazi Utalaba, a performer for the pupils. We are born about because of the competition. Ever now, I have a good team in. It was always been part of the plans. I want to car in any time I have a good way in. Utate life Manitoba. Kanga bepega peg. Yabona wal 7 to balagi. Ezi le mi dalabe dalaga against Australia. being omnye wabadlali bethu abagqabile kwindlela esidlala ngayo. And then enye into endla ngoyithetha ndisithi uba asikwazi kaloku uba too comfortable ku-select isquad esiyi-1 yabona, because of again awufuna ukuthi xa ufuna uyo win indebe yehlabathi 2027 all of a sudden 1 or 2 big injuries in some of the key positions, all of a sudden funa ukuyoqaqaleni. Balekile abadlali sithetha ngabo ofasi no Sasha, sibanike opportunity and awukwazi ke ukhalaza bafumane opportunity njenge iqela le All Blacks, because probably yona team udali dominator test match level for a long time. So I think for Rabafana, yes, but I like actually against Australia, but I think they were not tested with ways of I lay on the club and the All Blacks, because so Kumbu, a lot of other All Blacks now, and the expected players with the team and by the world class players. I think Lambuzo oqala usike bese ke wathatha kuya kuba uzukhumbule kalokuba abanye bethu siyazi la Freedom Cup uphumelela lo mdlalo, at least sizasipha ithuba sibeke iposition eright basikwazi ukuphumelela. Enye into abantu abayilibalayo kukho iArgentina nayo. Argentina iphumelele iluze only one game, and the All Blacks also they've lost one game. So if angaba umzekelo sinodlala kahle kulo mdlalo wangomso, izasipha ithuba ke ukuthi sikwazi ukuthi uphumelela iRugby Championship yonke kuphela. If angaba mhlawumbe sinophumelela ngomso, I think uzukhumbula iqela leArgentina badlala neAustralia kokwabo. And then the labadlala ngayo against All Blacks lamdlalo oqala kwabonakalisa ba the competition is about health yabo kule rugby championship. So kubalekele ukuthi ukubanga ba siyafuna ukuthi la uvula la gap between us ne teams sidlala nazo, kubalekele lomdlalo wangomso sikwazi noko sizokwazi ukuhlangana nathi for the first time nala Freedom Cup, and kubalekile sikwazi noko abalandeli bethu sikwazi bapha i performance enhle kodwa nase Ellis Park. And then always been umbuzo kana nibunga wa
football umgoki
umqedisi. Oh, okay. Now that the one thing about mna is at the moment umsebenzi wami ukuxhasa uRasil Rasmus as u head coach wethu. Eyona ndi focus yami ikuyo ngoku. Even nabanye abaqedisi bebe khona before Ozad bayazi landa kuyo. Mna as assistant coach, that is my job for them. Whatever abafuna idrive abone philosophy yabo. My job is to make sure bangayithini. Kule la kule one party players tibancedise to make sure ba siyakwazi ukuachieve le ndlela kufuna kudlale ngayo. Eyokuba ndiyabawula uba ngumqeqeshi, I think kuyo yonke nesenza abathini in all our departments, we all want to be the best in what we do. So if it means in the future maybe ndingafumana ithuba ndibe ngumqeqeshi wamabhokobhoko, into endivuyelayo for mna nefamily yam. But once again okwangoku loo nto ndikayijonge kakhulu, focus yam ukuthi make sure bandisapota Dr. Erasmus.
Last question over there.
So I have to. No, but isn't just a buya of Manil Tuba, and over say team in here. And because our yard, like I'm from the Foxtel and it is there's as one little team in Yams of BC Shore team in our yards, because they are Lama Abani be players, they are kicking you, other CRM Sansi. I mean, they are born in Michelin, they are Bugel, and they are born in Michelin. Nam Denzenga. Imagine I'm going to perform money injury, and then after injury, there's a plum part. You come to get a bit of a say campaign. So they have really lap and I'm charging and they tell it to a lamp because as a coach of a chill with Dallas in Lapatin. So Yanze, CC Luna Manda, because I call. I come to Uzaz Yuba, he showed us our team. So that's all like 17. I think Leo winner in Kalong, so then coach we pay the delay.